Hello friends, welcome to Quick Learn tutorial series. In this video, I will explain you mathematical analysis of class A commutation. So let's start with the topic. Before I discuss the mathematical analysis, I will give a brief introduction of class A commutation circuit diagram. But in my previous video, I have already explained the detailed description of circuit diagram of class A commutation and its operation with the help of waveform. The link of that video I will give in my description box. So let's start with the topic. Here Vs is the supply voltage, Is is the supply current, T is the thyristor, LC commutating component, I naught output current, R is the load resistance. The value of load resistance is fixed. We only choose proper value of L and C to make the system underdamped. Now the mathematical analysis of class A commutation. Here I explain the working of class A commutation with the help of mathematical analysis. First, we give firing pulse to thyristor T1 and thyristor T1 is turned on. When T1 is turned on, it behaves like a short circuit and output current flow in this direction. First, we apply Laplace transform to the output current. So we got this equation I naught equals to Vs by S upon R plus Ls plus 1 by Cs. To change this equation in the second order characteristic equation, we divide or multiply by S by L in both the numerator and denominator. So we got Vs by L upon S square plus R upon L S plus 1 by Lc. This is the second order characteristic equation. So we get the characteristic equation S square plus R by L S plus 1 by Lc equal to 0. Now we know that the standard characteristic equation is given by S square plus 2 zeta omega n S plus omega n ka whole square equal to 0. This is the second order characteristic equation. This is the standard second order characteristic equation. So when we compare these two equations, we find the value of omega n and zeta. Omega n equals to root 1 by Lc and zeta is equals to R by 2 root C upon L. We know that in order to make this system underdamped, zeta will be lie between 0 or 1. Okay. If zeta is lie between 0 and 1, this circuit is behave like an underdamped system. And the response of the underdamped system is like this. So, we know the condition of underdamped system. A circuit is behave like an underdamped system if zeta is lie between 0 or 1. I can write here, zeta is smaller than 1 and the value of zeta is R by 2 root C by L. We already find with the help of characteristic equation. Therefore, when we solve this equation, we get R square is smaller than 4L by C. Here, R is the load resistance. The value of load resistance is known. We choose the proper value of L and C in such a way the system is behave like an underdamped system. So for underdamped system, R square must be less than 4L by C. Okay. So in underdamped system, we will obtain the response of current like this. If we want to calculate the frequency of this underdamped system, we calculate frequency with the help of this formula, omega r resonant frequency equal to omega n root 1 minus zeta square. We already calculate the value of omega n and zeta with the help of characteristic equation. Now here we see in this waveform of output current, between 0 to pi, the output current is positive. So this time the SCR is turned on, and what happened after pi the output current is negative. So this time the anode current across the SCR is below the holding current, and when anode current across the SCR is below the holding current, the SCR is turned off. And we know that once SCR get turned off, it will not turn on. It will be turned on only when we give gate pulse to the SCR. If I will ask you, what is the turn on time of the SCR? So how we calculate the conduction time or turn on time of the SCR? We calculate with the help of this formula, omega t is equals to pi, because 0 to pi SCR is turn on. The output current is greater than the holding current across the SCR and SCR is turn on. So T omega are equal to pi. So we calculate the time duration at which SCR is turned on. So T equal to pi by omega r. We know that the value of omega r, omega r is equals to omega n root 1 minus zeta square. So here I write pi by omega n root 1 minus zeta square. So this is the formula to calculate the maximum turn on time of SCR. Now we know that sometime we turn on SCR at some angle phi or some angle alpha. Now we know that sometime we turn on SCR at some angle phi. So how to calculate turn on time of SCR for alpha firing angle? So it will given by T equal to pi minus alpha divided by omega r. So in this way we calculate the turn on time of SCR, the frequency of the underdamped system. All these parameters are very important for your competitive exam point of view. If you want to solve the numerical, these equations are very important. Let us consider if circuit is not work like an underdamped system. So the current equation is not like this. Positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Current is not like this. SCR will not be turned off. So if we want to turn off SCR, zeta must be lie between 0 to 1. This condition of underdamped must fully satisfy. So this is the whole explanation of class A commutation. These equations or these formulas are very important. So if you like the video, please like, subscribe and share my channel. For notes, please visit my website www.quick-learn.in.